Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. Two updates ago, I did a thorough analysis of the right angle geometry that we had on 27 and 28 March, and that this could easily trigger a mid-7 magnitude earthquake. It actually did trigger a mid-7 magnitude earthquake, but 5 days after the geometry occurred, it was in Taiwan. As you can see here on the SGI graph, magnitude 5.6 and larger earthquakes. Later on the second, a 7.4 in Taiwan. There was also an aftershock 6.4 and several aftershocks, major earthquake. You may want to look up that update from March 25th. We had a convergence of planetary conjunctions on the 3rd, and we see that there was a clustering of stronger tremors following that convergence. A 6.1 in Japan, 5.8 Myanmar, 6.8 at the Mariana Islands. Remember, on 4-5 April, I suggested the possibility of a high 6 to 7 magnitude earthquake, and indeed we had a 6.8. I mentioned that in the previous update. And then a 5.6 at Tonga late on the 5th. Yesterday, no larger tremors. Again, this is 5.6 and larger. And again, 6, and also today, relatively quiet, but we do have this lunar geometry, the lunar conjunctions yesterday and today, and that is probably going to trigger some stronger tremors, not necessarily big. We have a planetary conjunction that is early this morning, that is Sun, Venus, Saturn, and a high lunar peak, that is the planetary conjunction, as I explained in the previous update. Then tomorrow we're going to have a lunar eclipse, that's a new moon, and a solar eclipse, and that on itself is not really critical. If we go to the next SGI graph, we see here the blue peak, that's the new moon and also the solar eclipse, and then we're going to have a real critical convergence of planetary conjunctions coming up. That's on the 9th, on the 10th, and also on the 11th, we're going to have another planetary conjunction. There are going to be four planetary conjunctions, and that's going to be very critical. We have Mercury involved, we have Venus involved, and even the Earth involved. If we look at the solar system, how that geometry actually looks like, we see here Earth, and it will be in a conjunction with Mars and Saturn. That planetary conjunction usually triggers a higher 6 magnitude earthquake, around 6.6, 6.7 magnitude. And that's just this planetary conjunction. But we're going to have a lot more. As you can see, we have Mercury, Venus and Neptune coming up. Critical conjunction, because Mercury and Venus are both involved in a conjunction with an outer planet. And also, on top of that, we have Mercury in a conjunction with Jupiter and Uranus. And then on the 11th, we'll have Earth in a conjunction with Mercury and the Sun. A convergence of three or more planetary conjunctions can trigger a big earthquake. And if you look at the last time a magnitude 8 earthquake occurred, that was in August 2021. That's almost 2 years ago, and on average they occur a little over a year. That's on average. And the longer it takes, there can be 2, 3, sometimes even 4 years between two magnitude 8 earthquakes. But the longer it takes, the higher the possibility is. So we have this geometry from the 9th to the 11th, and there is a distinct possibility of a major or even a great earthquake, and that would be most likely from the 11th to the 13th. I think that's the most critical time frame. And if it takes a bit longer, we have this limit of up to 5 days from the moment of the critical geometry. But usually we see an obvious seismic increase, a clustering. It very much depends on the condition of Earth's crust, whether we're going to have several 7-pointers, maybe 2 or 3 magnitude 7 earthquakes is possible. It's also possible to have a single bigger quake. So be on watch, 11, 12, 13 in particular, the days following that critical planetary geometry, a convergence of three planetary conjunctions is really critical. We shouldn't underestimate that. You can look up the website, the About page. We have an analysis of the largest earthquakes since 1960, and all of them, the magnitude 9 earthquakes, all of them occurred after a convergence of three planetary conjunctions. So don't underestimate this. So it's not really the solar eclipse that's going to be critical. the eclipse path will be going over the United States, but the eclipse itself is not really critical. It's not really all that different from a new moon or a full moon, and on itself it's not really critical, and statistically they don't trigger large earthquakes. But if an eclipse occurs close to a convergence of planetary conjunctions, then it becomes really critical, and that's what we're going to have in the next couple of days. Check out the website and also the social media for updates, atmospheric fluctuations. We update that regularly, and it may indicate regions where larger seismic activity may occur. Again, be on extra alert in the coming days. There can be a big one. Okay, stay safe. Until next time.